already increased the troop levels by 20,000 earlier in the year, and he held a meeting at the White House yesterday with congressional leaders. Your sense of whether he will get the uniform support that Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid initially suggested might be coming his way, no matter what his decision is?
I don't have a sense of that. I do have a sense of the president and his deliberative process that he is undertaking, which I think is absolutely correct. And he's listening to a variety of points of views. And as a member of Congress, not as a member of the executive branch, but as a member of Congress, whose constitutional responsibility is to protect our troops, to make sure that if there are going to be military operations, that there is a declaration of war, I cannot support an increase in troop level because there, first of all, is no declaration of war. We have given the authority, I think unconstitutionally, to the administration to wage war, endless war, until, in fact, the administration decides that it's no longer needed.
Would you take the step of trying to block appropriations for the war effort if the escalation in troop levels goes through?
I have not supported any increase in appropriations for either the war in Iraq, the occupation of Iraq, nor the war and occupation of Afghanistan. My resolution would deny funding for any increase in troop levels. Now, let me just say it's a very hard position to take, and that is a very hard policy to move through the House of Representatives, but I cannot support an increase in funding for this. There are, you know, we need to look at Pakistan. Pakistan, unfortunately, has nuclear arsenals that we have to focus on. That's where Al-Qaeda is. When you look at Afghanistan, the poppy seeds the poppy fields, you know, are grown now. We're witnessing another influx in heroin in the United States. We have to look at a more comprehensive strategy as it relates to Afghanistan that requires more public diplomacy. Also, it requires more economic strategies to make sure that the farmers have alternative crops. And in fact, we have to really look at how we address issues with regard to women. We have to look at ensuring that our tax dollars aren't being ripped off by corruption. And so there are many, many issues with regard to Afghanistan in terms of the Taliban and in terms of contrasting that with what we need to do in Pakistan that we really need to focus on objectively and make some hard decisions there.
Well, General Stanley McChrystal is believed to be seeking 40,000 more troops to be deployed to Afghanistan. He said the situation there is deteriorating. I want to play some of his comments and get your response.
The situation is serious, and I choose that word very, very carefully. I also say that neither success or failure for our endeavor there in support of the Afghan people and the government can be taken for granted. My assessment, my best military judgment, as I term it, is that the situation is in some ways deteriorating. We need to reverse the current trends, and time does matter. Waiting does not prolong a favorable outcome.
Congressmember Lee, your response to General McChrystal and also to the critics who say that the politicians in Washington shouldn't be second-guessing the assessments of the military commanders.
Let me say the situation is deteriorating in Afghanistan. We've been there 8 years, and it has not worked, and it's deteriorating, so he's absolutely correct. The more military-first strategies that are employed with regard to Afghanistan, the worse it's going to be. The counter impact is what's happening now. More troops become occupiers as perceived by the Afghani people. The hostility, the violence continues to increase. And in fact, I'm not willing to want our young men and women placed in harm's way. It has not worked over the last 8 years. We're digging ourselves deeper in a hole. There's no military solution in Afghanistan. I believe if you look at history, you'll see that the British tried, the Soviets tried. This has a historical context, which we have to understand and remember. And so if it hasn't worked in 8 years, with more troops and more troops, more militarization, more occupation of that country. I think we need to look at new strategies and a more comprehensive approach to address the security issues in Afghanistan, as well as the economic stability of that country.
And finally, I'd like to ask you whether you think the allegations of massive fraud in the recent Afghan elections have had any impact on how your colleagues in Congress regard their willingness to support the continued U.S. presence in the country.
Well, we shall see. You know, it's really very interesting when I listen to many of my colleagues around the health care debate and the debate around the deficit and not wanting to fund universal health care with a robust public option. You don't hear that same kind of contrast and policy debate with regard to military spending. So I think we need to really be honest about what is taking place there. We need to be honest about our hard-earned tax dollars and where we're sending these tax dollars. And certainly there has been corruption in Afghanistan. There's been corruption in Iraq. We've spent $200 and some billion in Afghanistan, over $1 trillion in Iraq. We're trying to pass health care for Americans, for every man, woman, and child here. And so hopefully my colleagues will begin to be objective about our spending. And of course, I support and believe that our national security is first priority for all of us. And we have to ensure that. But I believe that there are better ways to ensure our national interests and our national security interests. And finally, let me just say, with regard to the critics who talk about elected officials caving in and not engaging in any debate, I think that is really very dangerous. Again, Congress has the constitutional responsibility to declare war. Many forget what the basic tenets of our democracy are, and that is dissent, debate, and offering different points of views, and that is what we are doing. And so for those who don't believe that our democracy should survive even during national security debates and discussions, to me, don't really understand what the true essence of American democracy is, nor do they understand the Constitution.
Well, Representative Barbra Lee, I want to thank you for being with us, the only lawmaker in either chamber of Congress to vote against the 2001 resolution authorizing the use of force in Afghanistan. She's also introduced legislation to prohibit funding for another surge of troops in that war. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to look at the situation on the ground in Afghanistan 8 years after the war began.